Hello, pretty people. Good to have you back to the channel. You've probably heard that Notion is this awesome tool you have to use for your business. And maybe you even started using it. But you're now trying to get some structure into Notion and you found that pretty difficult. So you started Googling and pretty soon found a lot of information on how to structure it for your personal usage, but not for the organization. And you're now at the just give me a decent example stage. That's where I'm going to help you out today. But before we do, I have to explain why this works so well and why the structure we've chosen works so well. The problem here is that Notion search really sucks. Because of that, you have to create a solid structure within Notion. The research field on how to structure information is called information architecture. And for the AI specialists, I'm going to oversimplify the next part of the story. Information architecture can be split into three parts. The first part is ontology. That means clear information that's up to date and that people can really understand. The second part is taxonomy. That is the structure and categorization of information so people can easily navigate through the content. The third part is chronology, which basically means that people experience flow when they're trying to search something within your system. The cool thing here is that Notion helps you out in all these three parts. Ontology, because it allows everybody in the organization to update information or add to it to create more clarity. And taxonomy and flow, because Notion allows for multiple hierarchies of the information, but also for multiple types of linking within the content. If you want to know more about this, you can find the blog somewhere up in this corner. So let's dive in to Notion. The first thing you will notice is that we don't have one knowledge base. We have multiple. The organization wiki, for example, contains all the general information on our organization, but also stuff like vision and strategy and how we have an impact. The next big element is our voice handbook for new colleagues. This contains everything on how we want to work together within the organization, which is a lot of helpful information for new colleagues and existing colleagues. The other wikis and knowledge bases you will find, they are basically there for multiple parts of the organization and they contain everything that's relevant, for example, for growth and marketing or for design. The knowledge bases are the first part of the system. The second part is for our circles and our roles. We're a self-managing organization organized around purposes within the organization. And each role or each circle, a set of multiple roles, has a purpose. These pages for these circles contain information that is relevant for them. It contains projects they're working on, project updates, meeting notes, and extra information like it. A lot of this information has a temporal character and is temporarily relevant. Project updates, for example, are only relevant while you work on the project, but don't contain long-term information. We have one basic rule within the system. As soon as information from a role becomes relevant for the entire organization and for the long term, you move it into one of the knowledge bases. This means you can find all the long-term information in there. The third part of the system are the personal pages, and I'll jump into mine. Personal pages are very personal, and in my case, they contain a lot of stuff I'm currently working on or interested in, or my personal manual, for example. These three things, the knowledge bases, the roles and circle pages, and the personal pages make up our entire information system. A good thing to remember is that the separation of temporary information, meeting notes, projects, project updates, from long-term knowledge is very helpful to also have the relevant information available at the right time for the right people. I've got one more thing to you, and that's that we're going to make the voice handbook public. It contains all the knowledge we've gathered on working together as equals and working without managers. It's going to be released via our newsletter, and you can find my personal newsletter and the link to that in the video description. So if you want to know when this becomes available, you can sign up there. I hope this video helped you out. I hope you learned a lot from it. And if you've got any feedback or improvements or advices and tips, please put them in the video comments. Thanks for joining me today, and I would love to see you in the next one. Cheers.